Amen. Some of y'all need to take your medicine. Laughter is like medicine. Sometimes you got to stop blaming everything on the devil and just take your medicine. Amen. Yeah, you take some stuff so seriously. You know, they used to say that some of us can be so heavenly minded that we're no earthly good. And sometimes you take yourself so seriously, you just might need to just look at yourself and laugh. Amen. Because you are funny. Amen. So we give God praise. But listen, I want to utilize what has been given to us as the theme, amen, for this gathering concerning our wedding day to the Lord as we joining in a full commitment of service and renewed vision. That is what has been given as the thematic presentation for what is taking place during this commencement ceremony. And so, I like to honor that when they tell you that that's what it is, amen. I like to work with that. And particularly, I'm not here as the revivalist per se. I'm not really supposed to be preaching. I'm speaking. How many of you know the difference, amen? But I'm still him though, so he gonna do what he do. Come on and give God some praise in this place. And that the foundation there, it comes from Revelation and the 19th chapter of the book of Revelation. Amen. Though two verses were selected, I believe Reverend Stephen said verse 7 and 8. And if you don't mind, I just want to back up a bit to help with the backdrop of this particular pericope and deal with verse number 6. And so if you would go to Revelation 19, verse number 6, and then those two verses following, we'll jump into it because I'm the speaker. I'm not preaching, per se. I don't have to worry about the opening 3 points in the close. So anyway, so if we will just go there. Revelation 19, verse number 6 reads, "And I heard, as it were, the voice of a great multitude, as the sound of many waters, as the sound of mighty thunderings, saying, Alleluia, for the Lord God omnipotent reigns. Let us be glad and rejoice and give him glory, for the marriage of the Lamb has come, and his wife has made herself ready. And to her it was granted to be arrayed in fine linen, clean and bright, for the fine linen is the righteous acts of the saints." Amen. The reading of God's blessed word. Pray with me. God, help us. Amen. Listen, as we move forward, my brother, with this in mind, and considering that this is, in fact, proclaimed to be the wedding day. I don't know how many of you got married or been through a wedding. Sometimes you've been the bridesmaids a few more times, and you know what, we won't mess with that there. But you know about the wedding day. Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Considering the wedding day, there's much preparation for the day. But most importantly, it's not so much the day, my brothers and sisters, being honored and having honors and degrees bestowed upon you. It's not really so much about the day, but the life after the day. That's where the marriage really gets to get known. Pre-marriage counseling ought to take place. There ought to be study. There ought to be an understanding. You know, do you really want to do this? Do you really know what it is that you're getting into? Do you know what you are doing? Amen. And yes, it's caused by love. Pastor, it's an amazing thing that whenever I have a couple sitting before me in pre-marriage counseling, I come in and I'm generally dressed quite casually, and then I sit down and they wonder when we're going to start. I just look at them and mess with them for a little while, you know, try to intimidate them for a little bit. And my first question is, so what are y'all doing here? And let them say, because we want to get married. Then my second question is, well, why y'all want to get married for? They look at me as if I'm crazy, as if I don't realize why they really are here. And it is amazing to me, 99.5% of the time, the number one response is, because I love her.
Yeah.
Because I love him. Ah, the foolishness of love.
Come on,
and so here comes marriage as we concern even these people who are married, amen, into the work of the Lord. So, but when we look at love, and people have to get this. This thing, he gonna help you, not just for today. This gonna help you wherever you are. The problem, I have a problem with love, me personally. Because love, even as we look at what love says that comes out of 1 Corinthians in the 13th chapter, I know y'all know about that, nowhere in there does it talk about emotion. It's got nothing to do with your emotion. Love has nothing to do with how you feel. It is completely about commitment. It is completely, love is not for wimps.
Come on, Doc.
Love is not an easy thing to do.
Yes.
Problem I have with love is that love, real love, will cause you to do things you do not want to do.
Come on, Doc.
Problem with it is that love will have you doing stuff that you don't feel like doing.
Yes.
But because you love, amen, here you go doing it anyhow. Or you may not feel like keeping hope. You may not feel like covering. As a matter of fact, you might feel like exposing. But because there is love,
yes,
love covers all, believes all. Come on here, somebody.
Yes.
Amen. And so here we come now, ready to receive degrees and be honored, amen, and deal with the theme of this wedding day. And as you are handed documents and as you are hooded, and I love how you put this thing together. You make me work a little bit more than I thought I'd be working. Amen. But the way you put the thing together says that when we stand up, amen, beyond your initial servant, we used to call it trial servant, amen, but beyond all of that, amen, you come to this place and there is a great honor. Please understand that to honor the honor, there is honoring and honoring the honor by honoring the honor. What does it say? Doing what it is, the reason that you are being honored.
Yes.
Come on here, somebody.
Yes.
Too many people look for degrees. I heard my sister, she was all in here, so the Holy Ghost is working here. Too many people, amen, look for titles and all this kind of, but it really is about the work.
Yes.
And I believe that if you just do the work, the title will find you.
Come on, Dr.
As a matter of fact, don't even worry about the title, just keep doing the work.
Yes.
We got a lot of folk, they say they the bishop, amen, they ain't covering nothing.
Come on, doctor.
Amen, they just got titled. And some, they don't even really know what real apostleship is.
Come on now.
Y'all don't like this part here. So as we move forward, amen, the gathering of this wedding, this enormous undertaking, this is no joke here. This is an enormous undertaking. It's an enormous proclamation, amen, but there's an enormous groom. Y'all already know who the groom is up in here. Amen. And verse number 6, the reason I needed to pull in verse number 6, Reverend Stevens, is because this is the only place in the Bible where the word omnipotent occurs. Amen. Omnipotent, which means mighty and almighty, having unlimited power. And so when you couple that with Lord, which means supreme in authority, and God, which means supreme deity, you have an overwhelming understanding as to who he is and what he is and what his abilities are. Great place to give God some praise right there.
You're right,
you see, because so many times we think that God is just the God of roses, and we get into our worship and we are celebrating the God, the sweet rose of Sharon. He is my peace. Oh, I love him. Oh, God is awesome. But baby, let me tell you, God, amen, is it will go to battle on you quick. God will also destroy some things and tear up some things and pull down some things. God will also kill some stuff.
Come on, doctor. Come on.
He ain't just the God of peace. And the God, he is also the God of war.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is. As a matter of fact, we say this in funeral time and we leave this part off because blessed the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. But don't forget that other part, whether he give or whether he takes. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yes.
So it don't make no difference how you feel, amen, or what just happened. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Great place to just give God some praise. We keep on moving. I'm almost through right here. Y'all doing good. You're doing good. This pericope here, though, this pericope, y'all hear pericope. I'm using my big words for you. Amen. As we have gathered with this grand retinue of ecclesiastical pontificates,
right,
who have come to celebrate and to be hooded. I got some education up in here. Amen. You have to understand that unlike days of old, many times our audiences and our congregations, they are also educated.
You got that right.
Old school, back in the day, the preacher used to be known to be the most educated one in the community, and so the people would come to the church to learn from him and to hear from him. And so really, everybody couldn't even read.
That's
where we get our metered hymns from, and that's where we get our call and response, because they could open the Bible, but they couldn't read the Bible.
Come on, doctor.
They could have had a hymn, but they didn't know what the hymn said, so somebody had to call off the first line. Amen. And then the rest of them would follow whatever it was he said.
That's right.
Amen. God is my shepherd, and I shall not want. God is my, because they ain't know what it said.
Come on, doctor.
Amen.
You're right.
And so also then they could tell them anything.
Come on now.
And called it the gospel. Heard somebody say, don't you play with God. Come on and give God some praise up in here. Amen. Yeah. But here we see heaven and Babylon is discussed. Here we see the church, we see the commitment, we see the promise, we see the challenge, we see the instruction, we see praise, we see worship, and hallelujah, we even see pageantry. And that's what we got on our stuff. Amen. You got to realize that, you know, some of y'all fanning like crazy, but this is part of the training. This is part, see, old school, I'm so glad I came through the tail end of old school. Old school was, I don't care how hot it was, we could not take our jacket off.
That's right.
I don't care how hot it was, you better not take that collar. Am I right? You couldn't take that collar off.
That's right, doctor.
Amen. Amen. I don't care, choir, I don't care how hot it is, you better not take that robe off.
That's right.
Amen. Because the garment means something.
Oh.
Who it is that you say you are. Can't walk around, because if even if you unzipped it, you are half dressed.
Come on, doctor. You're right.
And so we learn, part of our training, we learn to just sit and be content and deal with it. Because this is who you say you are.
That's right.
This is who you say you want to be.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Then you need to sit.
That's right.
And deal with
that's
it.
Right. That's right.
Because you a doctor.
That's right. Come on, doctor.
You need to master this thing.
Come on now.
And there are times when you are sitting on the pulpit, sitting on the dais, sitting on the podium, and you have to look as dignified.
Yes. Come on, Dr. Jim. Come on.
Make it as you want to be.
Come on, make it plain.
Yeah. Because if it were that easy, everybody would be doing it.
Yeah.
If it were that easy, anybody and everybody could have it. But because you went through something, come on somebody, amen, then that's part of the thing that sets you apart and what causes you to be a part of this grand wedding day.
Yes.
Now this is not just any chapel wedding, you know, and as beautiful and meaningful as that day may be, amen, this is no couple before the justice of the peace type wedding, as meaningful and wonderful as that may be. This wedding, this marriage, as any should be, is long-lasting and far-reaching, beyond tangible, beyond imagination, positioned for the occurrence of the miraculous.
Yes.
As two becoming one can be. The majesty of this marriage creates a thunderous sound from its participants. There ought to be a thunderous sound from its participants. You see, the groom and the bride, for considering if they in fact become one, then there is a power that she has authority to access, just as he gives and provides.
Yes.
As in a marriage, she has a wide range of unquestionable authority. Oh yes, she does. Yes, she does. Hello.
Yes.
Hello, ladies. Yes, she does. And you, a man who are being married into ministry, yes, there is an unquestionable authority that comes with this. When she speaks, he speaks.
Yes.
So you have to be careful with what you say. Amen. Because there are some people that don't know him,
mm-hmm,
as you know him.
Yes.
And so they believe and they trust. And particularly if you have gone as far as ordination and are now reverend,
yes,
as far as doctor, and once they understand that there is mastery with you, then they have a justifiable reason and a clear right to be able to trust you.
That's right.
To trust what you say.
That's right, doctor.
And to believe.
That's right.
I'm just speaking. We just talking. I'm not really preaching yet. Amen. And so because of this honor that is being bestowed upon you, there is absolutely an impeccable challenge. Great place to just give God some praise anyway. It'll help you get through it. Yeah. If this is in fact the wedding day, as these honors are being bestowed upon you, and then let the example of the marriage begin. Keep speaking what he says to speak. Keep speaking what he says to speak. The great honor in participating in the ceremony, there ought to be a continuous praise report regardless of the matter. Because they're looking at, you have to understand that you are the only Bible that some people may have ever read. And so sometimes they're looking to see what you're going to do, to see what you're going to say, to see how you are going to act in this particular situation. And so yes, there is a charge to carry this word. And I mean, when you carry the word, you got to carry the word as is. Straight, no chaser, hold the sugar, deal with it. Amen. This is not no mix.
Come on,
y'all looking at me like, y'all, come on y'all, don't stop playing. Amen. This thing here comes straight, 100 proof.
Come on, Doc.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, you have to be prepared with no place to preach than to find yourself with a place to preach and not prepared.
Come on, Doc. That's right. Go ahead, Doc.
There ought to always be a word. There ought to always, I don't know.
Come on, are you right? Come on, Doc.
I mean, if you really ought to be honored, if there really is, ought to be a degree to your name,
come
if
on,
there
Doc.
Really ought to be an additional title to your name, and if you feel like you can't handle it, you don't have to let them do it.
Come on, Doc.
Teach, Pastor Bell, teach.
And you feel like, I don't want to do that, and maybe nobody told you that, because see, problem is, a lot of times, our family puts us up in places.
Come on, Doctor.
Woo!
That's the reason some of them folk were sounding so bad on American Idol. It was a mess. But what happened, see, the family told little Judy that he could sing.
Come on, Doc.
So at the family reunion, he was singing.
Come on, Doc.
At the house, he was singing.
Come on, make it clean.
With all his cousins. Hey, you want to hear him sing. He got to American Idol, and it was a mess.
Come on, Doc, make it clean.
Because them folk be lying to him.
Come on, Doc, make it clean.
And so this is serious business. And if you're not ready for the serious business of what's taking place in this wedding here, amen, be it earned or honorary or whatever it is, you are connected.
Come on, Doc. Come on.
Don't wear it if you ain't ready.
Come on, Doc.
Don't accept it. I don't care if they want to give it to you. Amen. Even if you earned it, went through all the classes, and don't even hang the certificate up if you don't mean it.
Come on, Doc, make it clean.
You ain't got to tell nobody that you went through seminary for 4 years, for 2 years, for you ain't got to say, if you don't really, really mean it.
Come on, Doctor.
Shut your mouth.
Come on, Dr. Bell.
I'm going to tell you.
Come on, Dr. Bell.
When you open your mouth comes an expectation.
Come on, Doctor. My God.
Amen. Yeah, because I'm about through. I'm getting ready to go to the close part. So since I'm about through a couple minutes faster than I thought I'd be through, let me help you right here. All this is free stuff. I'm throwing out trying to help somebody.
Come on, Doc.
Amen. Because the point is that people have lied to people. And some of it is this. Some of about even a deliverance service. Some folk ain't been delivered.
Come on, Doc.
I'm talking about the folk with these. I'm talking about with this on right now.
Woo-hoo.
Amen. You can put your cross in the left-hand pocket with the collar and wear a purple shirt and still,
come on, Doctor,
not be delivered.
Go ahead, Doctor.
Amen. And there's no big sin, no little sin, but guess what? The gift still comes without repentance. So go look for my perfection. Look for my perseverance. Look for how I'm still pressing through anyhow.
Come on, Doctor, go ahead.
And I'm just doing good.
Yes.
Can I tell you, I have not been delivered from cussing at all.
Come on now.
I haven't. Some of y'all not ready to tell me, wow. No, I haven't. But I'm doing very well.
Yes.
Let us not be weary in well doing.
Go ahead, Doc.
For in
Come on, doctor.
Just because you know the number don't mean you got to call the number.
Come on, doctor.
Just because you know how to put it together and what to tell them and how to tell them and line it all up don't mean that you do it.
Go ahead, doctor.
It's the reason I smile so well sometimes. Because they don't know. Yes, you know what? I couldn't really. Ooh, that would have been so good. I couldn't let you have it.
Come on, man.
But God. Can we give God some praise?
Hallelujah.
And so, and as the text talk, you know, so just let us be glad. We're the glad folk. Let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to Him. For the marriage of the Lamb is come, and His wife, those of us, amen, the church, we are part of the church, amen, His wife hath made herself ready. And it's a daily thing.
Yes, it is.
You listen, you ain't got ready and think you just ready. You got to continuously get ready.
That's right.
Continuously. Mama say, if you keep the house clean, you don't have to worry about cleaning the house because they're coming over. I ain't messing with y'all, but you know how you do. Sometimes, because you find out somebody coming over, now you got to clean up.
Amen.
Keep it clean, you don't have to worry about it.
Amen.
Amen. Keep that word in your heart. You don't have to worry about finding a word.
Come on now. Come on.
Keep a prayer. It always amazes me when you call on somebody to pray. This, you know, so that kind of shows that you ain't been praying at home.
Woo.
You ain't been praying in the car. Do I have any bathroom prayers up in here?
Yeah,
you ain't been praising at your cubicle, at your desk, in your office, in the studio, wherever it might be. There ought to always, because there's always a reason to give Him praise.
That's right.
To thank Him and to bless His holy name. The text describes a volume. The volume ought to be loud from these. And not necessarily an unseemly loudness, but a volume that says you're present. Yeah. Sometimes, you know, you have to realize that even in silence, there's still a volume.
Yes.
Because presence ministers. Sometimes you ain't even got to say nothing. You ain't got to be on the program. Amen. But presence ministers. Amen. You can walk in a room and they'll say, there's Reverend Dr. So-and-so.
Yeah.
And you just sit down and just understand that presence ministers. You hear. You don't always need to be up here with the mic. Amen. But presence.
Come on, Doc.
Ministers. And so there is that volume. Amen. And so be it doctor, be it master, reverend, man, woman of God, honor the honor by keeping a word. I wonder, is there a word in the house?
Word in the house.
Amen. It feels like it's about a 2-month-long revival up in here right now.
Come on
and let's give God some praise. Come on and bless His name. Somebody on the shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now since you went to Revelation 19 and it stirred me up so as I read what you needed, and I'm through, I'm really finished, but let me help you with this right here. Because Paul says finally several times before he's really finished. But finally,
yeah,
finally. In that same book, and I'm going to go sit down right here, amen, because there is no greater close coming from Revelation 19 than what John has already given us. And he says it right here. He starts at verse number 11 and he goes down. Now I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and he who sat on him was called faithful and true. And in righteousness, he judges and makes war. His eyes were like a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns. He had a name written that no one knew except himself. He was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. And the armies in heaven, clothed in fine linen, white and clean, followed him on white horses. Now out of his mouth goes a sharp sword, that with it he should strike the nations, and he himself will rule them with a rod of iron. He himself treads the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God. And he has on his robe and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I ain't got to tell you who he is, but this is the groom who has come into the room, amen, in this grand celebration with his bride. Now, if I have just introduced you to him, and if you really believe that he's in the room, and if you are ready to receive this honor, I should not have to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, amen, he is yet with us. Now, if I said it was the President of the United States, amen, y'all be standing up screaming, shouting, and excited because Obama came up in here. But baby, he can't do what 8 years. But there is one, amen, that can be with you and has already been with you down through the ages, amen. Somebody want to thank him for many dangers. Thank him for your traveling mercies. Thank him for the grace. Thank him for his mercy. And his traveling mercies are not just because you made it through the highways and the byways and the streets of the DMV, but truth be told, he has granted you traveling mercies through many dangers, toils, and snares. You've already come. You want to give him some praise for being with you. When you didn't even deserve to be kept, he still kept you. When you didn't deserve to be blessed, he still blessed you. When you didn't even deserve to be honored, he yet honored you. And can I tell you this? According to Psalms 8, he has crowned with glory and honor. Oh my God. You want to go ahead. I know you got your thing, but you want to understand that whether you got one of these on today or not, amen. What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou should visit him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and have crowned him with glory and honor. God bless you, honorees. God bless each and every one of you. May the love of Jesus Christ continue to keep you and to be with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.